Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, the planet Mercury, the elusive planet Mercury, is going to reach greatest eastern elongation, which means it's visible in the western evening sky. So it will be 25 degrees east of the sun, which seems like, woohoo! 25 degrees east of the sun, 25 degrees is this far, like that's a really long way, so I should be able to see Mercury really easily, right? No! Unfortunately, you will have to use these binoculars to see this just about for sure. However, you have something in your favor. The first thing is Venus is nearby, so that's going to help you find it. Let's take a look and see what this whole 25 degrees thing is about first, though. So if we take away the ground here on Stellarium, just for a moment, you can see where the sun is. So there's the sun, and if we bring up our measuring tool like this, we can see, oh, hey, look, there's the sun, there's Mercury, it's about 24, 25 degrees away. So yeah, it really is 25 degrees away from the sun. The problem is, and when we put the ground back, is that Mercury is only like, 6 degrees above the ground, the horizon at around this. I'm only showing this at like 15 minutes after sunset, which I kind of consider like the golden time to look for Mercury, as like a half hour to 45 minutes after sunset. So we're 15 minutes ahead of that even. Now, I was able to see Mercury this evening on the 17th of October with binoculars at about 20 minutes, maybe 20 to 25 minutes past sunset. So it was visible sooner than that half hour point. And Venus was definitely a helper, because Venus was right over here, and I measured over about 8 degrees, which was just more than a field of view that I could see in the binoculars. And after some scanning for a little bit, for about 10, 15, 20 seconds, I was able to pick out Mercury at about 20 to 25 minutes. I was also never able to see Mercury naked eye the entire time, and I looked for the planet until it was about 2 degrees above the horizon, which it's pretty difficult to see naked eye no matter what when it's 2 degrees above the horizon. So binoculars are going to be the only way to see this. But you have something else in your favor. The more we go through the next week, week and a half, Mercury actually gets closer to Venus, which is going to make this easier. So watch what happens. We'll take out that and watch how Mercury and Venus get closer. Now, this is an 8-degree measuring tool right there. Watch this. On the 19th, and then the 20th, and the 21st, 22. You can see how much closer they're getting. Now, granted, they're getting a little lower in the sky because Mercury's starting to drop now, because it's past the 20th, so it's really dropping down. But look how close Mercury gets. And then, this is the best part. On the 29th, bam! Look how close the moon is to where Venus is going to be. I mean, you're talking, this is like 3-4 degrees away. That's within the same binocular field of view. And Mercury, right down here, look at this. That's only like 2.5 degrees away. You might even be able to get all three in the same binoculars field of view. And the moon is super thin right there too. Now, I don't know if you'll be able to see it on the 28th. That's, I think, like a day past new moon, which is really difficult to see. But give it a try. You'll be able to see Jupiter, because I was able to see Jupiter this evening when I was looking at like 20 minutes past sunset. Jupiter was pretty easy to pick out. And as soon as I kind of like pan my binoculars over, because the sun was below the horizon, so I didn't have to worry about anything, I could see where Venus was pretty easily too. So you can just draw that line of the ecliptic, and we'll bring up the ecliptic here using markings. So ecliptic of date, right there. There it is. So the moon is going to be above it, but see how Saturn, Jupiter, Venus, bam, moon is going to be not far away. On the 28th, you're only looking at 9 degrees over. You can just kind of pan just straight over along the horizon, because Venus is only, I mean, that's only like 3-4 degrees above the horizon right there. So just keep Venus, you know, in your field of view and pan over and go down just a hair more than, you know, one binocular field of view. And you might be able to see a super, 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 super thin crescent. Check out how small this is going to be. I'm going to zoom in on this. I mean, there's almost nothing there. Look at that. That's it. Just that little teeny tiny sliver. I mean, it's only magnitude 4.6. For the moon, that's nothing. Moon is normally like at, you know, minus 12.7 when it's full, so that's not a lot. And the next day, it gets brighter. Now you're at magnitude, you know, minus 7, and there's a lot more there. See how there's that crescent you can actually see now. But give it a try on the 28th as well. So Mercury and Jupiter and Venus, and I want to show you, this is actually a photo that I took. This was about just around 35 minutes past sunset. So here was Jupiter over here from my observing location. If I don't know if you can notice, but Venus is right down in here, and I'll zoom in so you can see that. It is right there, right above where these three silos are. Mercury would have been right in here. My camera did not pick it up. I was using my Samsung cell phone. But to be able to pick up even just what I did, it's not too bad. Now, the great thing about having some kind of landmarks like this visible is that I was able to use this telephone pole to pretty accurately keep on finding where Mercury was. When you have a landmark, now the planet's going to move this way towards the west because as we rotate, it's going to kind of slide down that direction. But you can use landmarks to help you as you're looking for things. So that will definitely be beneficial. And then even when you're trying to measure like your field of view, I was able to measure a field of view out to about here and say, oh, well, I know that I need to be approximately around here when I started looking. So that was helpful as well. You can definitely do that. But look for the moon there on the 29th for sure. You can even look at it on, you know, the day after too. We're going to have it on either side of Jupiter on the 30th and 31st. If you aren't doing the trick-or-treating Halloween thing on the 31st, here in the States anyway. And then we can back up and go back to Venus here on the 20th, when Mercury really should be at its highest, which it's never really going to be at its highest. One thing that you can also do with Stellarium is you can show the planet orbits to show where they're going to go. So you can see how Mercury doesn't really get very high. I mean, let's go forward in time just a little bit and see if even the dot of the planet will come up. See, it's just barely there. And look how, you know, 18th, 19th, it's kind of up there. And then, you know, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, not very high. But very similar in altitude to Venus. Now, keep in mind, this is only like 2 degrees above the horizon. Mercury's going to be difficult to see there. The closer you can get to Mercury being at like 4 or 5 degrees, that's going to be better. 3 degrees is still kind of visible, but not naked eye. Or at least I couldn't see it naked eye. Maybe you will have a little bit more transparent skies than I did, but you will need a very low, very clear west to southwest horizon to be able to catch all of this. And again, you can start with Jupiter, head towards the sun, find Venus, and then find Mercury by just looking left a little bit. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.